Hi, I'm Dr. Alan Widener from Massage Chair Relief, and today is our bi-weekly massage chair industry update for Monday, January 22nd, 2024. Thank you so much for joining me today. As I mentioned in my last broadcast, I was planning on attending the Consumer Electronics Show in Las Vegas, which I did, and we'll talk about that in a moment. I'm also next week going to be attending the Las Vegas Furniture Market at the world, I can't remember what they call it. It's a huge facility with three monolithic buildings, just full of furniture throughout. And it's a place where distributors and manufacturers come to show their wares and to find people to sell their products for them, retailers and other and local distributors. So it's always fun to go there. I enjoy going to that. CES, which is what I was just at just over a week ago, was fantastic. And what they've done is they've grouped all the massage chairs, most of the massage chair companies, close together. So it was very easy for me to find them and to visit with them. And I'll tell you, I started off by going to Human Touch, and they have a nice big booth right in the opening of the, I think it was the center hall at the convention center in Las Vegas. And they had the new Supernova 2.0 and the Supernova X. Now the 2.0 is out already, and we've talked a little bit about that. There are some subtle differences between the 2.0 and the regular Supernova, and those changes include a little bit different roller track. They call it an IntelliTrack 3D advanced SNL roller track. They also have now, on the original Supernova, which is still available, it's not being discontinued, that chair doesn't have an auto scan system. You can set the height of the rollers for your own spine, which is kind of neat because you can change it at any time during the course of your massage. Well, they've also added now a shoulder memory detection feature. So whoever the last person was that sat in the chair, the chair will remember where you set that shoulder height. And they'll recreate that for your next visit on the chair. Also, the Supernova 2.0 is going to have the apps for Droid and Apple, so you can operate the chair from your phone. The current Supernova has an Alexa feature that is, there's a bridge device between your chair between the voice response and the chair that you can use to say, you know, Alexa, do this, Alexa, do that. And so now this one has just an app on the phone. It also has a USB port, which the other one had, but it also has wireless charging for your device. And it's a heavier chair. This one is, it's a little bit lighter chair. I'm going to talk about the Supernova X. That's the heavier chair. But it's about the same weight, and most of the rest of the features are pretty close to the same. Now, that chair is out now. So if you want the Supernova or the Supernova X, the Supernova or the Supernova 2.0, they're both available in the market now. The 2.0 is $1,000 more, so its list price is $10,999. Now, the Supernova X, which is their innovative new chair, they had there, and I had a video filmed of me in the chair with Victoria Laddock, who's the Human Touch Director of Marketing, going over the features of the chair, and it was interesting to sit in it. It's a strong chair. It's got a split track feature, so it's going to be able to give you a stronger stretch. It has calf rollers and calf kneading on the airbags, which will give you a stronger calf and foot massage. Other features that chair has is the panels, the side panels of the chair, the panels on the armrests. By the way, those armrests go up. So the Oco opened up, the Loraco, or the Oco M8 opened up. The Loraco I9 chair has the sliding armrests that come back like sliding doors. And this one has armrests that come up. So there's three different variations of armrests opening to allow people to enter the chair from the side. And for people that have pretty intense back pain, which I've had in the past, I know how difficult it is to mobilize, especially when you're trying to get into a massage chair. It makes it very easy to access the chair. It's just like getting into a car. Or for those who are you know, just elderly, and it's like, it's hard. I've seen some people that are quite elderly try to get into a regular massage chair, and it can be very bothersome. You know, you're trying to negotiate backwards onto and falling into the seat of the chair in a standard massage chair. These newer chairs that have the armrests that move out of the way allow people to, elderly people to come in through the side, like getting into a car. So it makes it easier to get in. That chair is also 369 pounds. So it's about 50 pounds heavier than the Supernovo. And I was going to say about the panels on the armrests, the panels are interchangeable for different colors. So you've got a pad set that can be a different color, and the panels on the side of the armrest can be a different color. So the interesting thing about that is, if you ever want to change the look of your room that you have the chair in, you know, maybe change the color from one theme to another theme, you can change the armrest panels and the pads of the chair to match the new decorum. So for example, the base is black across the board, on all the Supernovo X chairs, the base is a black color, but the pad set, it can be black, espresso, which is a very dark brown, cream, gray, or tan, and colors. And the door panels can be black, espresso, cream, gray, tan, red, gray metallic, or wood grain design color. So they've really come a long ways in accommodating the inner interior decorator in us all. And I personally don't care much about that, because I never colors and stuff like that. I mean, it matters to me that they match, but, you know, matching a decorum, if I have a black chair in a just a regular, maybe a white themed room, it doesn't bother me as much, but it definitely, my wife would definitely have a bone to pick with choosing the wrong color. So anyways, there's lots of flexibility with this chair. Also, it has what they call the multi-dimensional duo sync roller track. They call it a flex track, which is basically a split track. They just got their own name for it, their own vernacular. I told you it has the calf rollers. It has the kneading. They call it orbital motion, but it's kneading or oscillating calf airbags. It has definitely a stronger stretch than the other Supernovo chairs and it has the last used memory shoulder detection feature that I talked about with the Supernovo 2.0. And it also has JBL speakers instead of the Altec Lansing speakers in the original Supernovo. And you know what? Altec Lansing, JBL, both great quality speakers. No other massage chair boasts brand name audio equipment as part of their massage chair Bluetooth music system. So that's pretty cool. And also the seat dimensions are 1 inch wider on the X as opposed to the 2.0 and the regular Supernovo. So you got a little bit more width, not as much depth. I think it's about an inch less in depth. Actually, it's a couple of inches less in depth. So you don't slide back quite as far in the chair when you sit in it. And that may facilitate, and I'm not sure, I can't remember when I sat on it, may facilitate the rollers going a little bit further down into your calves because the seat moves back a little bit. I don't know. I can't remember. So I'm just blowing smoke now. But anyways, those are the major differences. Oh, and the pricing on that chair, it depends on what pad set and what panels you get. For example, the pad sets, the gray and the tan are leather, whereas the black, the espresso brown, and the cream are a synthetic leather, what they call soft hide. And also the gray metallic and the wood grain on the panels is a vinyl as opposed to a soft hide for the other color. So there's a $1,000 difference in pricing. So the chair can range anywhere from $14,999 with the chair with one of the soft hide pads and one of the soft hide door panels, but it can also increase $1,000 for a leather pad, or $1,000 for the gray metallic or wood grain vinyl. So the price of the chair fluctuates from $14,999 up to $16,999, depending on the features that you get, those accessory features for the armrests and the pads. I hope that's clear. I hope I haven't over-talked that. Also, other new models coming out The Cinco Wellness, which is, and I've explained this in the past, Cinco Wellness is a company, part of the parent company, Johnson Wellness Tech. And Johnson Wellness Tech purchased, I believe it's called Mount Fuji factory in Japan, which created the Fuji Yorkie chairs in the past. But the Fuji Yorkie chairs in the past were not distributed in the United States very well. And now they are being distributed by Cinco Wellness and Johnson Wellness Tech, which is the parent company of the factory. And so they're going to be introducing a whole new line of chairs, beginning with three chairs under the Fuji Yorkie name brand. And those are Japanese made chairs. And I was talking to Nicholas Beese, who is the U.S. guy, the guy that runs the U.S. operation for the massage chairs, and a very knowledgeable guy. I really enjoy talking to him. And he's going to be one of our guests on our live stream, I believe, in March. And he's going to be talking about three new chairs from Fuji Yorkie and some very interesting stuff coming out of that factory that I've not seen before in terms of aesthetics, in terms of trying to make it look and feel more like a piece of furniture. The top chair will have that, something along those lines. And then two other chairs below that. And then there's two more Chinese made chairs coming out for Cinco Wellness. So they had a lot to announce at CES, and I'm excited about that. I'm going to be flying down to Southern California in the end of February to check out the chairs. Hopefully the chairs are in by then. And then we'll kind of discuss it live on our live stream in the first part of March. So very exciting developments there. But he didn't really show me. He didn't have much to show me yet. A lot of it's pretty secret. But I'm looking forward to see what they get. And he thinks that they'll have a couple of models when I come down to visit in the end of February. And so that's for Fuji Yorkie. And it's a weird spelt name. It's Fujiiryoki. So Fuji Yorkie. And of course, Cinco, their part now, it's all the same company, different brands. Cinco also has the Inner Balance line of chairs as well. So that'll be three different brands for that company. And speaking of the live stream, Christy Kim from, she's the owner of True Massage Chairs, which is a brand that we've been carrying for a couple of years now. And we had her on, and they're based in Georgia, and they have some nice chairs. We have the True Eclipse Plus, Symphony chair. And in my Utah store, we have the True Iconic chair, which is a little bit lower price point. But the new Eclipse is brand new. It was the original Eclipse, which we have in our showrooms, but then they upgraded it to the True Eclipse Plus, 4D Plus. And that chair comes with a 3-year labor, 5 years parts warranty, as does the True Symphony. The Iconic has a 1-year labor, 3 years parts, which was their previous warranty for all their chairs. But because of the improved quality of the chairs, from the factory, they're going to bump up the factory warranty to 3 and 5. So that's pretty cool. That is on their new Eclipse 40 plus and their Symphony models. And if you want to go full 5 years parts and labor, it'll be $350, and that's on either a factory warranty, whether it's the 3.5 or the 1.3. They will have the extended warranty, 5 years extra for 350, or not 5 years extra, sorry, 5 years total. So on the Eclipse and the Symphony, it'll add 2 years of labor because the parts are already at 5 years. The Iconic, it'll add 4 years of labor, 3 years, 2 more years of parts. Of course, we have a lifetime labor warranty. So that extended warranty for the Eclipse, you don't really need that because we're going to be giving you a lifetime labor warranty anyways. So, all right. And so that was, and you can see that live stream. It's on our YouTube channel. I posted it last week after our time together, and it was definitely great talking to Christy. Good to talk to. It's always good to talk to people from the industry, but it's also nice to talk to someone who's kind of bringing new chairs to the market. And she kept saying service over sales, which is our kind of our motto as well. After sales support is far more important than pre-sale support. So, although I forgot to mention, they're bringing in a split track chair called the Crown. That will probably not be here until next quarter, but we will keep you updated on that. And I don't know the pricing on it or anything like that, but that will have a split track I think it's a quad roller on the bottom, two rollers on the top. And I believe that's coming from a different factory from, you know, the Infinity Daiwa Human Touch chairs, which all come from the same factory. So it'll be interesting to see how that chair is, and we're excited to see it. Also, going back to new models, Daiwa is having a new Supreme Hybrid X. And I sat in that chair when I was at CES, and that chair is going to have what will differentiate it from the current hybrid. And it's the same colors, the same body, same roller mechanism, but what it's going to have is the ottoman will extend out a little bit further. So for long-legged people, it'll stretch, it'll go out a little bit further, and that's good. By the way, if you have long legs and you want to buy a chair and you love the chair and the legs just don't go out as far as you'd like them to, extend them out as far as you can and then drop the ottoman down. And that's what we've always told people to do, and it does work. Because the problem with a short ottoman is that your knees stick up higher, right? And if your knees are sticking up higher, that means your calves aren't buried into the calf wells, and you're not going to get massaged effectively there. And also, it means that your thighs might be coming up off the seat a little bit. So drop the ottoman down, and it'll bring your knees down. It'll bring your calves fully into the calf wells, and it'll bring the back of your thighs down flush onto the chair. Well, onto the chair seat. Well, when you have an extended, a longer foot extension on the ottoman, well, then you don't have to worry about that as much unless your legs are really long. And some people have really long legs. I mean, that's one of the reasons why the Loraco says they can handle someone up to 6'10". It's not just because the chair back will go up to their neck. It's because their legs extend so far that it can handle someone who's got the legs of a person who's up to 6'10". So anyways, that is the new model from Daiwa. I went to the Body Friend booth. I didn't sit in any of the chairs, but their chairs come from the same factory as Daiwa, Infinity, Human Touch, and some of the Osaki chairs. And they have an interesting chair that has legs that go up and down independent of each other. And I've never seen that before. I haven't sat on it. I don't know if it's a gimmick. I don't know if it's legit. But we are going to be visiting. When I go to Southern California in February to visit with Nicholas at Cinca, I'm going to also be dropping by a Body Friend because they'd like us to carry their chairs. But their business model for the U.S. market is very different. A Body Friend, in case you didn't know, is the number one massage chair retailer in Asia. But in the United States, it's been a little slow. It's been a little slow relative to other companies like Infinity and Osaki and Human Touch and Daiwa, because they have a very different distribution model. They would like to have more retailers, but a lot of people are afraid of jumping into their business model, which is, again, different from what we're accustomed to. But anyways, I'm going to be visiting with them at the end of February as well. I hope to. That's the plan. And then I can give you more information about that. I just want to say, when we talk about new models, and there have, and I don't know if you remember this, a few weeks ago in my newsletter or in my massage chair industry update, I said, you know, there's not really a lot of new chairs coming out. You know, I knew about Supernova, the new Supernova chair, but it was kind of like the no Supernova models. But man, I went there on CES and it was like, bang, okay, Daiwa's coming out with a new model, bang. Cinca is coming out with five new models, or two and three for Fuji Yorki, and then so I kind of felt like, holy cow, I'm a little behind the scenes or behind the times on these new models coming out. But I will tell you, I call it the glitch stage. When a new chair comes out, and you know, we see this with pretty much every new model that comes to market. We call it the glitch stage. In the beginning of a new model, there's the factory and the retailers are working out, or the distributors are working out glitches in the chair. And how do they find out if there's these glitches? Well, the testing of real customers who buy the chairs and then have a problem with it and then communicate with the massage chair company or their retailer and say, hey, this chair's got a problem. And then the massage chair company, the company that imported the chairs or had them made overseas, will contact the factory and say, hey, we're getting a recurrent problem with this glitch. And it's the glitch stage because they're going to fix it. But some people are turned off if they get a brand new chair and it's got a glitch right off the bat, even though it'll get fixed. But there's some people that just don't like that. And then they return the chairs. And increased returns results in increased costs. and increased defective chairs back at the distributor. And so they don't want, nobody likes a chair that has glitches. But in the early stages, you'll see that. So people are saying to me, hey, when can I get a hold of this model? Or when can I get a hold of this model? And I usually say, well, you know, the chair's coming out in such and such a month. But, you know, maybe give it a couple of months before you commit to it to make sure that there aren't things that the factory didn't find or flush out during their testing. Or if the distributor of the chair, like, you know, Human Touch or Sinca or Daiwa, they find out that there's some issues with the chair that were never discovered or flushed out earlier. It's kind of nice to get that out of the way so you don't have to worry about being one of the guinea pigs, if you will. And guinea pigs, maybe that sounds bad, but you kind of feel like you are on a brand new chair saying, because it's exciting. It's like, I'm the first one to get this chair or one of the very first people to get this chair. But you may also be one of the first people to have a problem with the chair too. So anyways, and just be aware of the glitch stage on new chairs, because that's the one time when you might not see that happen as much is if it's a chair that has been repurposed or rebranded under another company name. So, for example, let's say there's a chair like the original split track chairs, the ones that Daiwa, Infinity had, were basically from one factory, and so the roller technology for the most part was just replicated, maybe with some tweaks for each different company, so it makes it a little bit different. Maybe the chair body has some different features. Maybe the peripheral features were changed or different, but the technology of the roller track is essentially the same. Well, you know, when the first company that came out with them, Daiwa, came out with them with the Supreme Hybrid, at least in the US market, you know, they probably had to iron out a few of those glitches. Well, then Infinity came out with their Circadian and their Luminary. And, you know, maybe they were able to avoid some of those problems because the factory fixed them on the pioneer of the retail distribution, which was Daiwa, at least for us in the United States. So there are some exceptions to that rule. But if it's a brand new technology and that we've never seen before, kind of like Larocco chair, maybe like these new Fuji Yorki chairs, these are all brand new chairs. And I do believe they are. Well, the Larocco, their original i9 was brand new technology. Their i9 Max, which was an upgrade, is like that's the glitch free model, because they kind of fixed all the glitches with the i9 and then introduced the i9 Max with some other features, which made it an even better chair. But you know, so you'll see these things happen with new models, and it you know, if you're not afraid of you know, maybe being one of the guinea pigs on a brand new chair and seeing maybe that your chair might have a glitch, but it will get fixed. They always fix it. And if they can't, they'll replace it. So you're always going to be okay. But if you're not afraid of that, well, then everything I just said is pretty much a moot point. But anyways, I just wanted to tell you about what we call the glitch stage. Lastly, we had, there's not many sales going on right now. You know, after the holidays, you know, Black Friday through New Year's, it's fairly busy time with sales. But as of the 15th of January this month, the sales have pretty much knocked off. The only company right now that we were emailed a sale about is Ogawa, and they typically have sales every month. You know, their Ogawa Active L 3D is $37.99. Their Master Drive AI 2.0 is they say $8,099. That's not the price. I can't remember what it is, but anyways, it's $4,000 off. The Ogawa Active XL is $38.99, and the Master Drive LE, which is their new model, is priced at $67.99. So that's what's going on in the current sales. Of course, in our showrooms, we have certain floor sales, in-store sales. So you can always call one of our showrooms or our toll-free number to find out what's cooking. But those are the published advertised prices that I'm aware of right now, that I think that we have right now. And if you want to know weekly what our updated sales are, you can, if you download our free report on our website, and if you scroll down on the homepage, you'll see the area where you can download the free report. You'll be put on our, digital. We have two newsletters, but this is the digital newsletter, And this one we send out every week. And that has an update on sales, on new models, on a feature article or feature video. So there's more up to the minute kind of stuff in that digital newsletter. And I think that's it for this week. It was, exciting time at CES, exciting to see what's going on. Oh, and I'll talk about that another time, but there are some other factories that were there represented there. And there's one factory in particular that we'd like to see if we can carry one of their models. There may be some issues with it because they have some of their own stores, but anyway, I'll give you more information as that is learned. And of course, so we're going to the furniture market in Las Vegas. I'm just going for the one day on January 30th. And I'm going to be visiting the Cozy Ogawa JP Medics company. Then I'm going to be visiting Infinity, and I'm going to be visiting Osaki Titan and try out some new chairs there and visit with old friends. I really enjoy going there. It's not quite as chaotic as a Consumer Electronics Show, but I get to spend more time talking with the people that are very knowledgeable in the industry. And I really enjoy that. So whatever I learn and whatever we do, I'll share that. If you want to see what we did what I did at CES, you can go to our blog on our website. And I wrote an article about what I saw and everything. Basically, I told you now, maybe a few extra things. But I also have that video, the video of me sitting in the Supernova X, if you want to check that out. Excuse me. Anyways, I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please feel free to thumbs up, like us on our YouTube channel. We appreciate it when you do that. And of course, help us spread the word about massage chairs by sharing this video or any of our videos with any of your friends and family on your social media platforms. But I'm Dr. Alan Widener from Massage Chair Relief, and I'll see you again on the next video. Bye-bye.